this and putting it mildly, maybe not, have become mortal enemies like today.
Tony, it's such a strange situation because as far as Buff Bagwell is concerned, we've been on an emotional roller coaster ride with this young man. I think back to Columbia, South Carolina, the night of the very serious neck injury. And then when he returned to the World Championship Wrestling Organization, he aligned himself with the NWO. All of the times throughout the months that we had to put up with the mockery involving him and Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner. But as you see, the NWO and Scott Steiner, I believe in particular, is referring back to a TV title loss. And ever since the time that he lost that belt, he has turned on his former tag team partner, Buff Bagwell.
Well, look at the way the man looks. He's very proud of his physique. He's very proud of his wrestling heritage. And Bagwell's got to understand this is a high technical piece of wrestling machinery. And if one thing goes wrong, well, he's going to have to take the brunt of it. A man like Big Papa Pump is you're going to handle him with almost kid gloves.
Well, think of all the months that Buff Bagwell was there for support. He was in Big Papa Pump's corner through all of the good times. And you're going to tell me that because of one errant chair shot that you're going to turn on your partner just like that?
Well, maybe he wasn't there for the whole run. Maybe he was there riding off his coattails. Well, maybe he's a parasite. I don't know. I'm just throwing things out hypothetically.
Okay, if the Bickersons don't mind, I'll get to the play-by-play here. It's Rath and Mike Enos to go at it one-on-one. You know, I really agree with both ends. I mean, obviously, Bagwell was there for him, and obviously, Steiner is very proud of his ability, but you can't discount the ability of Buff Bagwell as well. It may get down to an ego thing. They both are very proud of their bodies, and maybe they look at each other thinking, well, I got the better-looking body here. There's so many variables there. The fact remains that I'm sure down the road we are going to see these two former friends get in the ring together. That's something I'd want to see.
You know, I don't think Scott Steiner has any friends. If he turned on his own brother, he couldn't have any friends. But then again, a lot of people don't like their brothers and sisters and cousins and aunts and uncles. You know, most families, people are just a bunch of losers. They're just a bunch of mooches. All they want to do is leech off you and get you to invite them over for cookouts and have them to your house for vacations. And just a bunch of deadbeats, low-life mooches. Yeah, maybe he's right. Now, my family's quite nice.
Boy, there's a lot of anger deep down inside of you.
No, it's have you ever top.
Have you ever talked to anybody about this?
Yes, I did.
There's anger inside of you.
Yeah, I went to psychiatrist Siegfried and Roy in Vegas and talked to them.
Enos in a shoving match. I should have gone there with Rath.
That's a good show.
And Billy Silverman, the referee. Rath, who has been so lethal, so dominant in his matches, going against a man who's had a run of success here as of late, Mike Tenay and Mike Enos.
Well, both of these wrestlers have been, as of late, very successful in WCW rings. Rath with that
roll
meltdown
up.
Quickly. The shoulders of Rath were on the canvas for a two count. And Mike Enos is one of those wrestlers who I think maybe along the lines of a Booker T is trying to categorize himself as a singles competitor after so many years. People thought of him as a tag team wrestler. But he's making headway and turning some heads, no doubt about it, in singles competition in WCW.
Just something about watching Rath. He constantly stays focused. And you can tell when a man's thinking of a next move, when he's thinking about his opponent, when he's thinking about what to do. He's totally shut out the people. You have to do that, and you have to concentrate on yourself, your ability, and the man you're wrestling.
Great drop toe hold by Enos as the big man came off of the right side ropes that time. Enos looking like he's very confident now. Rath goes head first. Into the mat, Rath, who you probably know, was also on Mortal Kombat, the series, on our sister network, TNT. But in the ring, he's one of the powerhouses.
Whoa.
And there's a display of it right there. Just hauled off that time in the clutches of Enos and putting down hard on the mat.
It's what we've come to expect from Rath, relying on more of that power game. Take advantage of that size and strength advantage that you have against your opponents.
Don't forget, fans, Ric Flair, world champion, president of WCW tonight against Barry Windham. In the cut.
You know, Barry Windham's also the man that turned on Flair just a short time back. Flair thought he was going to bring him to the ring, introduce him to great friend Barry Windham, and all of a sudden Barry turned on him, stabbed him right in the back. I like that when you don't see it coming.
I think that may be a little bit of the motivation for the Prez signing the match. Here's a roll up. One, two, got a two count. Just to show you, Mike Tenay, that Ric Flair is not ducking opponents. Going up against Barry Windham tonight. Speaking of ducking to the ropes. Thanks to a shoulder block that time, Enos hits the outside mat very hard. And Wrath is going to give chase here. Or is actually going to wait until Enos gets up. He goes outside. We have to take a commercial break. We'll be back with more of this carnage after this.
Hey, beer man.
We're back, and they're still on the outside. These two men for, gosh, over 3 minutes now have stayed on the outside. They have given it their all in this bout here on Thunder. And Mike Enos finally goes on the inside, feeling very good about himself here.
Well, he should feel good about himself. Anytime you got a man like Wrath in a compromising position, you got to be proud of yourself. Of course, it backfired on right there.
Wrath goes up top.
He's perched.
Fans are up with him. Wrath goes airborne that time, putting Enos down. He'll make a lateral press. Two, and well, still cannot hold him down. Only got a two.
Oh, that was just incredible. Wrath springing off the top rope. Three quarters of the way across the ring, he connected with the lariat. Now drops the elbow across the chest repeatedly of Enos.
Another cover. This time he hooked a near leg and put his back across the shoulders, across the chest, but still could not hold him down. So Wrath starting to fire back now from what happened on the outside. And it's like a sleeper hold here applied.
And at the same time, it's his chance to use the weight advantage that he has over Mike Enos to try and wear him down and take some of the strength out of Enos.
I don't think that's a sleeper hold apply. I think it's just more of a side headlock.
Well, at first it appeared to be a sleeper hold, but he has now modified that. You're right again, Brain. You've been right a lot on this telecast.
I was wrong once in 63 for about a half hour.
And a jawbreaker.
And take her out again.
And a headbutt now by Mike Enos.
Well, you know them all. You know all the moves.
I sure do.
You should put out an encyclopedia.
I should. Into the midsection.
And go door to door selling them.
Head first. Okay. Stay with me here, Brain.
I'm with you here,
okay.
Tony.
Going to educate you in another move here in a minute.
Uh-oh.
What's this coming up, Tony?
Okay, and for the call of this hold, let's go to Mike Tenay.
Well, that was a superplex, wasn't it, Tony? I mean, I don't want to step on your toes here while you're calling the match, but Enos off the top rope connected with the suplex on Wrath.
That's enough. Tell us what the name of the hold was.
Trying to crawl across the ring and make the cover. No.
Now, you got to hook the tights. You got to put your feet on the ropes. You got to distort the referee. You got to get where no one can see. You got to get a handful of hair. You got to get your thumb in the eye. You got to throw your arms back. You got to get a lot of things happening.
You know, there's nothing worse than a distorted referee.
Did you say distort the referee?
Distort him, yes.
Okay.
You know how to do that?
No, I don't.
You get a half a gallon of lighter fluid.
No, stop. Oh, that's a line of the day.
Sure. Haven't you ever watched TV when all your picture is all distracted?
Yes.
All of a sudden, we're working with Norm Crosby.
Tony can hear.
Mike Enos feels he may be moments away from winning this thing here. Drives the lower rib cage, the back. Enos again, using his weight here. One more time on the lower back here of Wrath.
About time Wrath gets up and does a little tail kicking of his own right now.
Have you noticed how Enos has slowed the pace down? Goes with the single leg crab, and again at this point, I don't think he's going to get a submission win with this type of a move, but he again slows down the pace and the momentum of this match.
Well, another thing too, Mike, you know, it takes away Wrath's ability to pick a man up real easy and use his finishing maneuver on him. He hurts the lower back on that man. Smart move.
Wrath just trying to use that upper body to power out of this, and he does. Enos with another shot on the back as he breaks away from the ropes, trying to pull Wrath back. Finally got him back to the center of the ring. Can Mike Enos pull an upset here? Drop the hold and a good one. Just a defensive move that time. And as a result, it hung him up on the middle rope. Rath again. What perseverance the big man has been showing here. Both men with a crossbody at the same time. One, two. And they both come right back up. Two big power men going at it. Reverse neck breaker that time on Turk. Enos could win it right now.
It may not look like much of that neck breaker the way he sat down and just snapped the neck, but that takes a lot out of you, boy. That jars your whole body.
Rath up. Rath picks it up.
That's no good for you either.
Calls that move the death penalty. He just drove Enos to the canvas. It could be time for the meltdown.
And that's what Enos was trying to stay away from.
Fans are to their feet. I believe they think the same thing. The pump handle.
Enos trying to fight him off. Not much left. Going to take him up to the shoulder. Oh, he got him up.
He's got him.
With the meltdown, Rath battled his way through that one, and you got to give Enos a lot of credit. That was a good matchup. And he pushed Rath to the limit. Rath comes away with the death penalty, followed up by the meltdown, and wins on TBS.